Hi, welcome to episode 6. Today, I'm going to show you some tips for finding assets more quickly. Also, I'm going to introduce what's special about Eagle's Smart Folder and how to use it. Let's begin with the search bar. In the upper right corner is our search bar. It is the tool in which you can type any keywords and find what you need instantly. Click the magnifier icon next to the search bar, then check or uncheck the search options to narrow down the search scope. When you click the search bar, it will show 5 recently searched keywords for your reference. Type anything into the search bar and it would suggest keywords relevant to your input. Now, if you want to filter out contents you don't need, use minus and type the keyword you want to remove. Eagle will then remove contents that include this keyword from the search result. The funnel icon next to the search bar is the filter, which you can use to narrow down your search results. Click it and the filter panel will appear down below. Depending on what kind of assets you're looking for, you can set various conditions, including colors, tags, folder, as well as others. Some conditions might be used a lot more often than other ones. In this case, you can rearrange the filter conditions by dragging frequently used ones to the front, and it will be more convenient for future usage. Smart Folder is one of Eagle's features. With this function, Eagle can automatically collect assets into a folder based on the conditions you set. Once you create a smart folder, new images that meet the conditions will also be added to the folder. For instance, you can set color as the condition. Once you create this smart folder, all images with similar colors will be automatically added to it. Here's another example. You can use date imported as the condition to narrow down images you add within a specific time window. You can create smart folders named Images Saved Yesterday or Images Saved This Week. For more details and tips for using smart folders, you can go to the link in the description. This is the end of this episode, and I do hope these tips help you find the assets you need more efficiently. In the next episode, which is also the last one of our tutorial, I'm going to talk about things to keep in mind when you export assets in Eagle to your computer. I'll catch up with you later. Bye.